Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back after the break. You're watching Towards the Origin. And to all of those who have joined us through our Facebook page live, welcome to all of you. And inshallah, this program can be watched again on the following day, which is the next day tomorrow. And to all of those that wants to watch us later on and wants to find us online, please feel free to look it up on the YouTube channel, inshallah. And of course, Facebook, our videos will also be staying there. We have been discussing today about on the topic Ramadan returns, and in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, who is one of the Imam and Khateeb of the Regent's Park Mosque. In the first segment, we've discussed about the importance of Sha'ban, the significance of Sha'ban, how should we prepare, how did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam prepare, and we have also touched about the lawful earning and income. Inshallah, in this segment, we'll be discussing about the importance of Ramadan and how we can prepare. And one of the important things that we all do towards the end of Ramadan, which is shopping. We'll have to find out how can we make sure that all of this is done and planned in according to the principles and according to the Quran and Sunnah, so that we can make sure that the Ramadan is utilized to the best of our ability. All of this, inshallah, we'll discuss in this segment. Now, Sheikh, you've touched, we have ended the first segment on the income issue, the halal income, and how you told us the importance of halal income and how barakah it will bring to the family and society. Now, the other thing also you mentioned that I wanted to touch upon, you said priority, the key word you've used, the word priority. Now, you mentioned that most of the people will be going for, many people will be going to for Hajj and
Umrah. Yes.
Now, ekhane amar prashno hocche, priority kor apni bolchen.
Yes.
Now, kuti kuti manush kintu proti bochori kintu especially in the month of Ramadan, especially the 10 days. Abar kintu dekha jacche tader kintu nijesho attiyo, direct attiyo kintu gorib. Tara miskin, but tara a financial ability nai, and they're not supporting them. Whereas they know the importance of supporting the kith and kin.
Yes.
Now, I just wanted to make sure, because obviously you use the word priority.
Yeah.
এই অবস্থায় এমন মানুষের মানে যারা যাচ্ছেন বা যারা চিন্তা করছেন যে কন্টিনিউসলি যাচ্ছেন, যারা গত বছরে গিয়েছেন, আর আগের বছরে গিয়েছেন, কন্টিনিউসলি যাচ্ছেনই, what is priority for them?
Okay, now I think it will depend on the individual. Like some people, what they do, maybe like some brothers and sisters, they don't go on a holiday, so they probably like, you know, just leave that holiday in the month of Ramadan, and so they just want to like go out.
But that will be very
relax.
Very few.
But if it's really for the sake of rewards and hasanat, then I would say like, then it's very important what you said, like, you know, there's lots of humanitarian crisis across the world, and especially before going to anywhere else in our own motherland, in our own country. So, and our neighboring country
and
as well.
Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, al-aqrabu fal-aqrab?
Yes.
Now,
yes,
we have our own relatives, perhaps at the country of origin that we come from, in our villages.
Of course.
And other places.
Yes. I mean, don't forget, like, you know, if you can save a person's life, you can imagine the amount of rewards. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, He loves that. You know, saving the life of a person is like saving the humanity. Just like killing a person like unjustly is killing the whole entire humanity. So yes, you're right that, you know, if it's just for the sake of entertainment, jodi shudhu eta entertainment er jonno hoy ba shudhu mane anondo ebong furtir jonno ba nijer jonno nijer ekta mane ekta baire gelam umrah korlam etar jonno hoy ami mone kori alhamdulillah amra যাই এবং যাচ্ছি মাঝে মধ্যে গ্যাপ দিয়ে আমরা আমাদের যারা নিকটাত্মীয় আছে আমাদের যে আত্মীয় স্বজন আছে আমাদের দেশে বা আমাদের যে পার্শ্ববর্তী দেশগুলো মুসলমান বিশ্বের মধ্যে মুসলমানরা কিন্তু অনেক ক্রাইসিসের মধ্যে আছে
জাস্ট টু ক্লারিফাই আপনি যখন এন্টারটেইনমেন্ট বলছেন ইউ রেফারিং টু দ্য হালাল ওয়ে অফ
এন্টারটেইনমেন্ট ইয়েস মানে মনে হতে পারে অনেক কিছু আছে হালালের মধ্যেও কিছু অনেক কিছু আছে যেমন এটা করলে আমার ভালো লাগে কিন্তু আরেকটা হচ্ছে খুবই প্রয়োজন It is very needed. It's really important. Our actors, I like it, so I'm doing it. So again, we prioritize. These are the, you know, matters of priority. But I would say, even if somebody goes to Umrah, then also let's not say, oh, where are you going to Umrah and this and that. Let's not also undermine him or, you know, discourage him. Because possibly that if that person is not going to Umrah, might go somewhere else or, you know, might spend, you know, his time in a different way, which may be not in the obedience of Allah. But at least we appreciate, you know, that love and zeal in the minds of people. But again, the priorities has to be made.
Same for Hajj.
Some people like they love going to Hajj every year. I would say, okay, I mean, if you've done your fard Hajj, the compulsory Hajj, obligatory Hajj, then, you know, maybe you may as well spend that money in saving the humanity. the humanity.
Or let other go. Give others the opportunity.
Maybe you have an uncle back home. Maybe you have an auntie, or maybe you have like somebody
facilitating others.
Exactly, like someone who is wishing. মানে তার জীবনের একটা প্রত্যাশা, আশা যে একদিন আল্লাহর বাড়িতে যাবে, মক্কা মুকাররমে যাবে, মধ্যে উনাদেরকে যদি আমরা ফেসিলিটি দিতে পারি, আপনি ইমাজিন করেন কত যে দোয়া পাবেন আপনি। সো ইট ইজ রিয়েলি রিওয়ার্ডিং। আচ্ছা, তারপরে আমি উমর ইবনে খাত্তাব রাদিয়াল্লাহু আনহু কথাটা ছিল, হাসিবু আনফুসাকুম ক্বাবলা আন তুহাসাবু, account yourself, assess yourself before Allah start assessing you or like counting your deeds. And then it's wazinu a'malakum wazinuha qabla an tuzanu. And weigh your deeds. মানে তোমার আমলগুলোকে তুমি নিজে ওজন করে নাও, আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিনে ওজন করার আগে। Weigh your deeds before Allah the Almighty start weighing your deeds. Now, of course, it's a time, an occasion where we must evaluate ourselves. And I think it's a time that we take some important decisions. আমরা একটু কঠিন সিদ্ধান্ত নিতে হবে আমাদের জীবনের মধ্যে, যে আমাদের জীবনের ডাইরেকশনটা কিছু পরিবর্তন করতে হবে। আমাদের সবারই কিন্তু ইম্প্রুভমেন্টের প্রয়োজন। উই অল আর ইন কনস্ট্যান্ট নিড অফ ইম্প্রুভমেন্ট, কারণ আল্লাহ পাকের যে প্রিয় বান্দা হওয়াটা এটা কিন্তু একটা সহজ ব্যাপার না। ইটস নট এন ইজি ম্যাটার টু বি লাইক এ ক্লোজ সার্ভেন্ট অর ফ্রেন্ড অফ আল্লাহ the Almighty.
Put it this way, if I have to be a good student, it's not that I only work hard once and that's it,
no.
Job done.
It's
there is
it's
a continuous process behind it to achieve the goal.
Exactly, yes. It's a lifelong process. Acha. তারপরে আমরা শাবান মাসে আরেকটা বিষয় আছে আমরা কিন্তু টাচ না করলে হচ্ছে না, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য শবে বরাত, যেটাকে বলা হয় বা লাইলাতুন নিসফ মিন শাবান বলা হয়। নাও শবে বরাত, যে দ্য ওয়ার্ড শাব ফাজিয়ান হুইচ মিনস নাইট, অ্যান্ড বারাআ মিনস টু ফ্রি ওয়ান সেলফ ফ্রম দ্য ফায়ার অফ হেল, মানে একজন নিজেকে তার জাহান্নামের আগুন থেকে নাজাত করা বা নিজেকে রক্ষা করা। সো লাইলাতুন নিসফ মিন শাবান, ইটস দ্য টার্ম ইন হাদিথ। Shab Barat, Shab is Persian, that's how it's known in our subcontinent, just the way we say Namaz. Namaz is not actually Arabic word, it's Salah, but we still say Namaz. And some other words, it's very common in our language that we use from Persian or Urdu.
No, but then again, there's a connecting question there, that Namaz, there is any Arabic word for it, Salah, we all know.
Yes.
So Shab Barat, what's the Arabic
word for that? Laylatul Nisf min Shaban.
So that's completely opposite of Shab Barat, because Nisf min Shaban is half of the Shaban, or middle of the Shaban.
Yes. And so Shab Barat, the night of Bara'a. So that's night of Bara'a, it's referring to Laylatul Nisf min Sha'ban, because that's when the hadith is talking about the Bara'a, obviously the forgiveness and whatever the hadith mentioned. So it's referring to the night of Sha'ban. Now, just one or two hadith by our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is a hadith which is mentioned in the book of Imam al-Bayhaqi, in the book of Iman, Shu'ab al-Iman. And this hadith is also actually authenticated by many, many scholars, including Imam Shaykh Albani, rahimahullah, who is a famous scholar of hadith in the modern time. And even himself, actually, he done tahsin, or he said the hadith is hasan, wa hassanahu al-Albani, rahimahullah. And that's also mentioned in the book of Imam al-Tabrani and also Imam al-Bayhaqi, rahimahullah, where the hadith says, إذا كان ليلة النصف من شعبان, if... Whenever the Laylatul Nisf min Sha'ban comes, or the night of Sha'ban comes, the half of the night of Sha'ban, or half of the middle night of the Sha'ban comes, then اطَّلَعَ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ. Allah Pak Rabbul Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes near to his creation. And then فَيَغْفِرُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, he forgive the sins of the believers, وَيُمْلِي لِلْكَافِرِينَ, and he doesn't forgive, or he... you know, leave the disbelievers on the side. وَيَدَعْ أَهْلِ الْحِقْدِ بِحِقْدِهِمْ حَتَّى يَدَعُوهُ. And then he said he also doesn't forgive the people who have hatred and a lot of grudge and enmity in their hearts and mind. He does not forgive them. But hadith refers and it has a connotation or indicates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forgives a big or huge number of people in the Laylat Nisf min Sha'ban, or the middle night of Sha'ban. There's also hadith mentioned in the book of Imam Sahih and Al-Jami' by Abu Musa Al-Ash'ari radhiyallahu anhu, where Allah Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah the Almighty, he comes in the night, middle night of Sha'ban, he comes to the lowest sky, fi laylat an-nisf min Sha'ban, and so he forgive, fayaghfir li jami'i khalqi, he forgive incredible amount of people, illa li mushrik, apart from, or except the mushrik, someone who commit or associate partnership with Allah, and someone who is mushahin, who has got grudge enmity jar mane heart er moddhe ebong kalber moddhe je ghrina ebong manusher proti kharap dharona manusher proti enmity adawa ei jinish gulo ache ওই লোকদেরকে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন ক্ষমা করেন না ওই রাতের মধ্যে.
Now, now, just to also add the other side of it, yes. There is also quite strict, a strong difference of opinion about this matter as well. We just want to make sure that it's an inclusive program, so we include the two sides of the story.
Not a problem.
So obviously, this is one side of the story, which is correct, perhaps according to you, what you said. But then there are other scholars who are very critical about this, certain narrations or certain
Okay, let me just clarify this here. I mean, just clear what I say. লাইলাতুন নিসফ শাবান বা শবে বরাত সম্পর্কে অনেকটা হাদিস বর্ণিত হয়েছে. ফিউ এ নাম্বার অফ হাদিস ওয়্যার নারেটেড. সাম অফ দেম, সাম অফ দ্য হাদিস আর কনসিডার্ড এজ হাসান, ইনক্লুডিং এজ আই মেনশন টু ইউ ইমাম আলবানী রহমাহুল্লাহ. আই মিন অ্যাকর্ডিং টু হিম ইভেন সাম অফ দ্য হাসান. আই মিন ওয়ান হাদিস, অ্যাট লিস্ট ওয়ান হাদিস হাসান. দেন দের আর সাম হাদিস আর কনসিডার্ড এজ দাইফ, উইক, অ্যান্ড সাম আর কনসিডার্ড এজ as like Hassan, or maybe like there is, you know, this in the science of hadith, it says when there's so many weak hadith come together, it gives a strength of authenticity. অর্থাৎ মানে কয়েকটা দুর্বল হাদিস যখন একসাথে হয়ে যায় তখন এইটা কিন্তু একটা শক্ত হাদিসের মান দেয়. You know, it becomes an equivalent to like a sahih hadith. This is called Hassan li ghayrihi. That's in the science of hadith. Now, there is difference of opinions. I understand this, but I think anybody who actually studied hadith science properly and fairly without being biased, then they would at least agree that there is some fadail in that night. Because that, you know, this that gossip that we hear today against it. I mean, I understand the people who do exaggeration. There's no
That's what I was coming to. Certain people, they think about this night, you know, or perhaps just in their whole
it's not only about this night, but people do in Qadr as well, in other nights, you know, and also night of Mi'raj. You know, our people, they have, it's lack of understanding of the religion. Some people, they just make sense. Some nights are just that. These are the only nights. But no, we have to do our good deeds, but there are some special occasions.
Very true. But also you have mentioned, just to balance it out, because with Qadr, there is a direct mention of it in the Quran.
Of course, yes.
With Mi'raj, there is a direct mention in the Quran. So some people might say, is there a direct connection to the glorious Quran? I'm sure we will discuss this down the line, because we'll be having a program about it.
But we must understand, we have to see the Salaf al-Salihin, our predecessors. You know, it's mentioned, if you really study independently, then you'll find the Jumhur al-Fuqaha, including Shafi'i, Abu Hanifa, Malik, and all those great scholars of Imams of Islam, they considered that night to be Mufaddala. And including Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he mentioned that it's a Layla Mufaddala. It is in the modern time when some scholars, and it's not only in this day, and I must be honest, in the modern time, some scholars, they're really critical. Why? Probably is because when they saw that some people are doing a lot of bad things, meaning like some people, they're doing exaggeration, decoration, they just take
or
that.
Or in the name of certain things, they are innovating ideas.
Innovating ideas and innovating that salah that probably mentioned in the sunnah. You know, that night is mainly, it's not about just doing something specific. It's mainly the
continuation of what you are doing.
And normal amal, dua, Quran, tahajjud, those kind of things, qiyam, like normal amal, we increase it, that's all. But there's nothing like specifically, even though some do say, you know, there are specific amal, but they're very, very probably weak or maybe fabricated, some of
but
them.
But it's just so basically, naturally, you're trying to say that obviously continuation of the good deeds that people do normally, but some people just make a money matter. They make it a financial gain out of it as well.
Yes. And also, if you have any, for example, kind of like discontentment about that subject, then you see, go and check the Darul Ifta of the Muslim world. So you'll find Darul Ifta in Saudi, this is Darul Ifta in Egypt, this is Darul Ifta in Morocco, Darul Ifta in Jordan. Check all the Darul Iftas, what they're saying at that time. And I'm sure you'll find the vast majority Darul Ifta of the Muslim world, you'll see they're talking about the virtues. You can check, anybody can check at this time. So again, I don't mean to say, if somebody doesn't want to do it, that's no problem. Like we said, remember in the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, Mashe, Amra Rasulullah Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Rahmat, when he dunyar mudde ashajen, oi mashke amra kintu gozober mash manai felai. Mane, we just start fighting and we start attacking one another, condemning one another. And same thing here, Laylatul Nisf min Sha'ban, hadith are mentioned, there's no need for debate and arguments. If somebody doesn't, I would say that if I don't feel like that these are correct, then okay, I know there are scholars who accept them and I respect their opinion. I may not be doing it, but I respect the opinion at least, rather than just saying, okay, these are just innovation, because this is unfair.
Thank you very much. And the other thing I wanted to clarify, during our predecessor, the scholars before us, and whether it be the classical or contemporary scholars, the students used to discuss.
Yeah.
I can't think a layman even debates on these issues.
And I think this is partly also some of the scholars, I don't know whether scholars I can say or not, but some of the scholars like really involve the layman into this. Meaning like when I say, for example, you hold an opinion and that there is a valid evidence from, you know, the scholars that you probably get the opinion or fatwa from. But then I say, okay, this is wrong, and I just like dismiss completely and dissolve. Now the laymen who actually love me, the people, the general people, those who love me and they follow me, you know, jara amake mohabbat koren, unara bolben sheikh to kokhono wrong bolte paren na. People really don't think people always go to evidence. No, people mostly look at the individuals, no matter what they say. At the end of the day, everybody, they have a sheikh in their mind. They may not say, but eventually they will say they have a sheikh in their mind.
But then again, the problem is they already have certain concept in their mind and they just want to endorse that concept by listening to that particular scholar, which endorses their already presumed view.
I think the responsibility of the scholars that when we mention any fatwa or any mas'ala, we say it fairly and we mention the difference of opinions. If we do mention the difference of opinions, that way at least the public will not be confused. For instance, some people say Ramadan awwaluhu rahma wa awsatuhu maghfira wa akhiruhu itqun minan nar. Ramadan er protom 10 din rahmat, majkan er 10 din barakat, ebong sheshe 10 din najat. Yes, some scholars say the hadith is da'if, but this is a practice accepted by the vast majority of Muslims of the world. Now, even I'm just shorat correct when I come and say, okay, this is not good and this is not hadith, then what am I doing? I'm confusing people.
So basically,
and I'm putting people in big dilemma.
Yeah, basically, in a nutshell, we have to respect and we have to listen to the scholars and let's not engage in this kind of debate.
And also, we have to go a bit more beyond 100 years, because most of the problems that occurred in the Muslim world regarding these debates of Islamic issues and things it happened in the modern time. Actually, after the fall of
and we've
Khilafah,
got much more bigger issues to deal with rather than these kind of issues. So, inshallah, we'll discuss that.
But
I'm
it's
sure.
important that we respect. Yes,
thank you very much for clarifying that. We're coming to the close of our program now. I just wanted to find a little bit more information about because I know down the line, inshallah, we'll be doing more programs about it. But how can one prepare themselves now when it comes to preparation? I want to touch one subject that is very close to me. We know about the importance of the last 10 nights or last of Ramadan. Yes. We know about how important it is. But this is the time all of us or majority of us, we get busy shopping, we get busy with our Eid for that one day, and we waste that last day.
Some of Muslims we have become like very much similar to the people of other religions, commercialized the way they made the religion commercialized and occasional. So we think, okay, this is a time coming, we'll do a lot of shopping, time of month of food, but it has shopping er mash hoye jabe, eta khana danar mash hoye jabe, you know, people manush kintu shopping center grocery shop gula
shopping center,
yes
where the
and some people maybe are doing Eid shopping now. You know, I've seen people like that. Kichu kichu lok ekhon theke kintu ider shopping shuru kore felchen, shuru korche.
Very true. Ekhon eirokom na, I'm sure you're an imam. Even we get questions, when is Eid? Ramadan hasn't started. Yes, yes. We're asking about.
See, we're looking for fun and entertainment more than the obedience. I mean, fun and entertainment come with the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
As you said, priority needs to be.
Priorities, yes. So we must obviously mentally and physically and spiritually prepare for this great month that is coming right in front of us, the month of Ramadan. Obviously, famous prophetic narrations where it says, "Man sama Ramadana imanan muhtisaba, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever fasts during the month of Ramadan with the faith and trust and with the anticipation of rewards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive his previous and the future sins, inshallah, by his mercy. So
when he talks about it, he's talking about the minor sins, not the major sins.
Yes, of course, minor sins as well as the sins that are not connected with the public, the rights of public people.
Huquq al-ibad.
Rights of people have to be forgiven by the people. Otherwise, Allah doesn't forgive. you know, somebody took the money, you know, and we have these things in our Muslim. People take mirath, like inheritance. They don't give their mirath to their fellow family members. And then they...
Unfortunately, we have seen murders takes place because of this.
You know, this is where, if you want to see the Islam of people, check in their dealing and transaction, how they...
Muamalat.
This is where, you know, you can see the reality of Islam and social events. How many of us we can actually observe Islam in our marriage events, like, you know, weddings and things like that? Many of us justify. We're saying, oh, ita khurazana, you can't do that. You know, there are things you can't do. How can you justify? This is not, a statement by a submissive Muslim who surrenders in front of the will of Allah.
But then the Quran says, أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ
بِبَعْضِ. And do you think it's not easy? Like, whatever you want, there's nothing impossible. When there is a will, you really try, inshallah, there's a way. And people are doing that, and it's not impossible. If you want to pray in your workplace, if you really try, then, you know, there will be a way. You know, you try, and inshallah, Allah will make it easy. So we cannot say that, you know, amra shob kichu mane para jay na ei kotha ta kintu musliman amra jara really musliman eta bolte parina eta
now apnar kache ami just shesh prosho ta amar thakbe eta first preparation kara what should be our first step karon actually shob kichu to obviously for everyone to do everything in one
go
won't be possible
what we can
do with the first initial step je ami ramadan ta prepare korte pari
instead of planning the food that come after we plan, for example, like, you know, how much Quran am I going to read? Because it's a month of Quran. Don't forget. And it's the only divine thing that we have within ourselves. Because there's nothing about Allah in this world. Meaning, like, we know Allah is there, but we don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the words of Allah is a sifa. It's an attribute. So, kalam of Allah is something about Allah. And that's we have within our fingertip, Quran al-Karim. That's one of the most important thing that we focus in the month of Ramadan. All the scholars of Islam, like even the scholars of Hadith, Fiqh, they would leave everything aside in the month of Ramadan and engage in Quran.
That means you're telling to not only read the Quran, but also I think you wanted to, you meant even a little bit of understanding.
Of course,
gradually.
So what we do is those who do not know how to read, we learn Quran, make time in that month. Those who know how to read, let's improve. Those who... You know, those who have good Quranic recitation, try and do khatams as many time as possible. And at the same time, we attend the classes of the scholars who are giving tafsir and like different, you know, sessions so that we understand Quran according to the understanding of the scholars.
Tar mani hocche, in a nutshell, jekhane amra ashi, oikhan theke enhancement, ekta improvement.
Yes, go one step forward. Okay. We just can't say, oh, I know how to read Quran and I'm fine. No.
That's enough.
The scholars of Quran, they say, you know, we recite every day and, you know, it's the lifelong process. And every time you recite, your recitation get better. Like every time you cook, your cooking get better. Similar, the Quran is like that.
Jazakallah khair. I would have loved to find out more about it, but inshallah...
Yes, preparation is needed.
Next episode, inshallah, we'll be discussing more in detail about it. And our is up, unfortunately. And inshallah, next episode, we look forward to discussing more with you, inshallah.
Inshallah, if when do we have programs.
Jazakallah khair. With this, my dear viewers, we've come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion, a very important topic, Ramadan returns. Now, we have discussed in our first segment about the importance of halal income, about how to plan our Ramadan. And in this segment, we have discussed how we can do it. It's all about a process that is done gradually with the intention to continuously improve and enhance our not only characters, our behaviors, etiquettes, and how much we are practicing our deen. And the fundamental important thing, as Sheikh has mentioned, we can have certain aspects, can have differences of opinion. Let's not fight about it. Let's leave it for the scholars to decide and let us respect, have that mutual respect for each other. Inshallah, we'll continue our discussion. And most importantly, can we take a lesson, including myself, that we have to create the mutual respect with our surrounding. We have to be united. And there are priorities, as Sheikh has said. Let's deal with the priority basis, on a priority basis. Inshallah, then perhaps in the near future, we'll have a more unified Ummah and the community that we have here will be more unified. With this, we conclude here until meet you next time. Subhanaka Allahumma hamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jazakallah.